Красная земля, я мать. All right, Nicola, let me start with you and ask, tell us a little about where you come from, and you've been to so many places recently and also in the not-so-recent past.
Well, I was born 1973 in Belgrade, Yugoslavia, and to begin with. Mm-hmm. And I did my bachelor's degree at the Vienna Conservatory, my master's degree at the Curtis Institute of Music in Philadelphia. Right now I live in Milano for 2 years. This is my second year.
And how many languages do you speak?
Well,
come on.
Well, I can handle a basic conversation in English, Italian, Russian, German, and of course Serbo-Croatian, and French, like just basically.
that's okay, we'll get along. And you also have won several very important competitions, among them the Pavarotti, which we mentioned,
this
but also
is the biggest
most
one
recently,
I won. Yes.
the Leila Genzer competition too.
Yes, yeah. The I was really lucky to win the fifth and the last Pavarotti competition in 1995. And I'm really proud to say that I was in the first cast in 1996 in September at the Academy of Music in Philadelphia to perform with Mr. Pavarotti in the third act of La Bohème.
Mm. What was that like?
It was great, really. Yes.
Now, you're also involved in the Young Artist Program at La Scala. What is that?
Well, that is a new program, and we are the first generation. There are 13 singers, half of them are Italian, half foreigners. And that was also a very good experience for me. And I must tell you, I was kind of worried when I was like 21, 22, you know, getting out of Curtis. I didn't know what to do with myself. I thought, you know, to sing all Trovatores and Lucias and Traviatas, one shouldn't do before 26, 27.
At
so
least.
So I had this kind of, you know, 3-4 years, you know, which I thought, like, what should I do? And I was really lucky to, you know, that I went to Paris Opera House for a year, then now I'm 2 years at La Scala. I performed with Maestro Muti at the concert at La Scala in October this season, which was a very great experience. Mm-hmm. And
what did you do?
We did different, like, excerpts. It was the first concert of the how do you say?
The season program.
Yeah, of the season and also of the program mm-hmm. itself. And I also was a soloist at the Easter concert of La Scala. Then we did first opera by Wagner, Die Hochzeit, and the CD is coming in the market now. So many other concerts, and I had really great experience of studying with people like Leila Genzer, Luigi Alva, Renata Scotto, Renata Tebaldi.
Oh my!
You know, so it was it was nice. And one, it is a program though for the people who already do have certain technique. I must mention my very dear voice teacher, and I must thank him that he gave me the knowledge. And he made me able to, you know, sustain such a difficult program as I did today. Is Mr. Edward Zambara, who is in Boston right now, and I really thank him for everything he did for me, you know, for all the vocalizing and all the technical work we did together.
Now, you mentioned before you were out of Curtis and you were thinking to yourself, what do I do for a few years here anyway? And that leads me to the Marilyn Horn Foundation and to recital and concert work. Now, you did a Carmina Burana recently.
I did Carmina, my first Carmina Burana in Belgrade in end of September. Mm-hmm. I did also The Bells by Rachmaninoff mm-hmm. at the Teatro Lirico in Milano with the orchestra Giuseppe Verdi. Last season, I just did, before I got here, the 5th of March, Messa di Gloria by Puccini at the Accademia di Santa Cecilia in Rome.
And what about recital work?
I must tell you that I did half a recital at La Scala a month ago. It was Canto Forum, and it's a cooperation between La Scala and Opera Bastille. So. I was representing La Scala program, and then they had another tenor from the Paris Opera House. So But I must tell you, I was kind of worried for today because I don't even remember last time I did a recital, like a full recital.
So that's the problem, is that there are some wonderful singers who just are concentrating so much on opera, which is fine, but we need this repertoire. I mean, a lot of the repertoire that you're doing today, we have not necessarily heard before. A lot of it is not that well known. Tell us a little about the composer that you just sang before intermission, Milojević, I believe is his name?
Yeah, Milojević. He is a Serbian composer. Those songs were, I think, they were made like 1920s.
He died in 1946, yeah. I think.
So, yeah. So, I must tell you honestly that I don't know much about his life or something.
But have you sung the songs before? Are they new to you?
Yes, or? Yes. I sung them, and I like them very much. Mm. And also, one thing happens always when I sing them, and it happened also today, that I realize how easier it is to sing in your native language.
Sure.
For the expression, and you don't have to worry about all the, you know, double consonants or in English mixed vowels and mm-hmm. all of that. So, you know, I'm happy if you like them as well.
Giovanni, I want to get you to the microphone also. You are at the Metropolitan Opera now. And how did the two of you meet?
Well, we met last summer at the Renata Scotto Opera Academy. I was an assistant to Renata Scotto in our school in Italy. And Nicola was invited to perform a recital. And that's how we met. We rehearsed there, and we clicked. We started working well together. And then he mentioned he had this upcoming concert in New York. I happened to be here for my engagement with the Metropolitan Opera. So we decided to do it together, and it's been a great experience, I think, so far.
Now, what do you see for your future? Are you a pianist by yourself? Are you a, I will not use the word accompanist, but a partner at the piano with singers and instrumentalists, or do you want to be a conductor?
I am actually a conductor, primarily. I work at the Metropolitan Opera as a conductor and assist Maestro Levine and other conductors that come in, guest conductors. Nonetheless, I love to work with the singers and play the piano for them. For me, it's one of the best ways to do music, especially because when you play, you actually have a physical contact with the music you make, whereas when you conduct, it's more, you have to talk and you have to express in a different way. With the piano, it is more really a touching. You can touch the notes, you can feel it much more than when you conduct, even though the conducting experience is much broader and requires a lot more knowledge, if you want, and much more thinking in conducting, and maybe less immediate sensations than when you play the piano.
All right, now since the two of you are working together on this recital and have been working toward it, what have the two of you learned from each other in terms of music, in terms of being colleagues?
Well, I think that Nicola has a great spontaneity in what he does, and that helps. That gives me a way of playing for him and follow his instinct, and it helps to know that. And he also, in the rehearsal process, always stopped and said, oh, this word means this, so I want to do it this way, I want to have this feeling. And that also gave me a lot of input to how to go along with these ideas.
So we may have in the future a conductor who actually listens to the singers. How nice.
Yeah, well.
Nicola, what have you learned in the process of doing this recital and kind of preparing for it and working together?
Well, first I must thank to Giovanni officially, you know, that he played, that we did together this concert today. And he already said, you know, everything, how we met and everything. And I think that the difference between art and science is that in science, 2 + 2 makes always 4. But in the art, it shouldn't be that way. So the art, you know, you have to follow your instinct, your emotion, your mood, and in addition to, you know, all the calculated work. So when I heard him playing, I have this thing, when I see the person, I immediately or connect or I never connect. And it was really, you know, pleasure playing together with him. We did some things today which we didn't in rehearsals. And no, I mean in a positive way. And that's you know why I'm singing, and that's what I like about singing and performing, because you can never be sure, and the bigger risks you take, the better it is.
Mm. One last question, and that is, how did you get involved in the Marilyn Horne Foundation?
I was going to talk about that. Well, since I mentioned Mr. Zimbara before, in 1995, or was it for 1995, I went I auditioned for the Music Academy of the West in Santa Barbara, and where Mr. Zimbara used to teach vocal technique. And the director, artistic director of that academy is Mrs. Marilyn Horne. So I went there and we met in 1995, and I connected with her immediately. And you know, I studied with her. We did also a couple of master classes, public master classes. And I was supposed to do this recital 2 years ago, but then we shouldn't talk about that. It just didn't work out. And so I finally did it now. And it's really, for me, other than being a big pleasure, it's really a great honor for me to get to know Mrs. Horne and to, how do you say this? I'm getting confused with grammar. To be part of, to take a part of the, in the recital series, in the foundation.
Well, we're very glad that you're here and that you made it here. I don't know if I'm supposed to bring this up or not, but I might as well, since you had a little problem getting here. I heard that there was a possibility that you may not have gotten into the country or something. What was that about?
Well,
yes.
Well, I did get here.
We know that.
So, you know, Germans say, Ende gut, alles gut. It was very difficult, but it's not the first time. So, you know, unfortunately, the human stupidity has no limits. You know, and unfortunately, sometimes we waste a lot of time and a lot of energy, and I have to tell you, the most of my time I waste on administrative things, on like, you know,
don't
you
we
know,
all?
Just secondary things, yeah, mm-hmm. And instead of, you know, learning new operas. So mm-hmm. What can I can't change it for now, so I'm
well,
just dealing with it.
I think the best way is for us to keep you here, and then we don't have to worry for a while.
Okay.
Anyway, thank you both very, very much.
Thank you very much.
It's been
also
an honor for us.
il mio sangue e la mia fe. Te ne ricordi ancora? Te ne ricordi ancora? Or la mia fe. Serenata, la mia diletta è sola, e con la bella testa abbandonata, posa tra le lenzuola. Serenata vola, serenata vola, splende pura la luna, là nel silenzio. Stende, e dietro i veli dell'alcova bruna la lampada s'accende. Ora la luna splende, ora la luna splende, vola serena.
Oh.
sun goes down and the moon comes through to the monotone of the evening's drone. I'm all alone with you. All through the night I delight in your love. All through the night you're so close to me. I'm so pathetic that I always get found it best instead of getting him off my chest. So let him rest unexpressed. I hate parading my serenading as I probably miss a bar. But if this did it is not so pretty, at least it'll tell you how great you are. You're the top, you're the Colosseum, you're the top. Shakespeare's sonnet, you're Mickey Mouse. You're the Nile, you're the Tower of Pisa, you're the smile on the Mona Lisa. I'm a worthless check, a total wreck, a flop. Buddy, baby, I'm the bottom, you're the top. Tum-tum, when the jungle shadows fall, like the click-click-clock of the stately clock as it stands against the wall, like the drip-drip-drip of the raindrops when the summer shower is through, so a voice within me keeps repeating, near to me.
Now I will sing for you an aria, and I'm sure you're expecting to do that. So it will be di Provenza in mar, il suol della Traviata.
Ti trovo